basically chapter number 6 in your book. This is chapter number 6 of influence like that from influence in your book. First, what is influence line diagram? Okay. So in previous chapters, right, mind you, this topic, right, we will continue maybe for about 6 or 7 lectures, okay? We will continue with this topic for about 6 lectures or six and a half or five and a half, okay? But if you can understand this first 10-minute discussion, this first 15-20-minute discussion, then the whole topic will be very easy. Okay. Mm. Otherwise, you cannot get anything in next 6 lectures. Can you understand what I am saying?
Yes.
So if you can get this, what we are discussing now, right? Then it's like a window, right? If you can open that window, then everything will come. Otherwise, you will just memorize and you will just struggle. Okay. So try to concentrate now. Try to understand what is influence line diagram for. Okay. So for in previous discussion, right? We consider the fixed means static loads, right? Fixed loads and found the internal forces, right? What is meaning of that internal forces? Means the actions, shear force, bending moment, etc. So it's easy to understand, right? Until now, whatever was our discussion, we consider the load is static, its magnitude is not changing, it is not moving, okay? It is fixed.
Yes.
And then we try to find what is the reactions, force reactions, what is shear force, what is bending moment, is it?
Yes.
Okay. Then, however, it is important to find the reactions, shear force, bending moment when load is moving. Okay? So, however, it is important to discuss, to discuss the variation in reaction, shear force, bending moment due to moving loads. Example of moving load is, do you know any example of moving load?
Human.
Examples of moving loads are? Earthquake is dynamic load, it is differently. Moving load means
live loads.
For example, it is
like
loads from vehicles.
Right.
Means trucks, cars, etc. Okay, this is the type of moving load, right? Crane load, it is another moving load, right? For example, over here we want to design a crane for this room, right? So what we will do, we will put a beam over here, one beam over here, right? And then there is a support. With that one, this crane will move, is it? Then for these beams, this crane load is a moving load, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. So that is another example of moving load, right? So, and on the bridge, right? So what do you see? So there are girders, right? Beams, large beams, right? And load is moving, okay? So it's, sometimes it's huge, right? So it is from the trucks, and sometimes the bridge are used for the trains, okay? So itself the load is too much. Can you understand?
Yes.
Okay, so such analysis is discussed. Discussed under the heading of ILDs. Now, I can write a very important sentence. The effect of, okay, by the way, Do you know what is meaning of influence?
Like effect.
In Arabic, it is close to tasir. So it is, we are trying to study what is effect, or in Arabic, tasir, right, of a moving load, right? When the load is moving, what will be effect on the beam in terms of reaction, in terms of shear force, in terms of bending moment, right? So the effect of moving load at a point, the effect of moving load at a point is to be studied by drawing the, now we will draw three shapes basically, right? We will draw the ILD for reactions, ILD for sport reactions. Then next one is ILD for shear force, and ILD for bending movement. So basically we will draw these three diagrams. We will draw three types of diagrams. First diagram will be ILD for sport reaction. Then second will be ILD for shear force. Next will be ILD for bending movement. Okay. Now until now you studied the shear force diagram, bending movement diagram, right? So now let's see what is difference between ordinary shear force bending movement diagram and ILD for shear force and bending movement. Can you understand?
Yes.
So over here first we need to study what is the difference, right, between the ordinary shear force bending movement and the ILD for shear force, ILD for bending movement, right? Okay. So over here, next discussion, which is most important, and it will help you to differentiate actually what is ILD, right? So difference between ILD for shear force bending movement and ordinary shear force diagram, bending movement diagram. Okay. So over here, on this side, I will write whatever you know about the ordinary shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Here I will discuss about the influence line diagram for shear force and bending moment. This is called as ILD, right? ILD for shear force and bending movement. So it is ILD for shear force and bending movement. Okay. Now, for the first difference, what will be the first difference based on this discussion between ILD and ordinary shear force bending movement?
Ordinary static and.
Exactly. So, in case of ordinary shear force diagram, we have the static load, right? We have the constant static load, okay? It will not change in magnitude, it will not change in position, right? So in ordinary shear force bending moment diagram, here the applied load is constant. The applied load, right, is constant, and it is static. So it is not changing, right? This is a major difference, right? In case of influence line diagram, right? So what will happen? We will have a unit moving load along the length of beam. Okay? So for the ILD, a unit moving load along the length of beam is considered, right? A unit load moving along the length of beam is considered. So what it means, so over here, right, your load, right? For example, you may have the point load, you may have UDL, UVL, right? And all these are static, fixed, right? This magnitude will be, for example, 10 kilonewton per meter. This is 30 kilonewton. All these distances are fixed, is it?
Yes.
So it is fixed. But in case of ILD, what will happen? We will consider a load. And this load, right, it will be moving. We will consider a load, unit load, and it will be moving, right? So this magnitude will be 1, only 1, okay? It is not 10, 20, it is not UDL, it is not UVL. It is only 1 point load of magnitude 1, right? And we will consider it will move from here to here. It will keep on moving. Can you understand the first difference?
Yes.
Any load, but static. Here, only unit load, and it is
moving
all along the
beam.
Length of the beam, okay? So for example, this position is here, it will change, right? Okay. Then, second difference, okay? In ordinary shear force bending moment diagram, the shear force and bending moment diagram gives the value at each point along the length of beam. Okay? So here, the ordinary shear force bending moment diagram, shear force diagram and bending moment diagram gives values of shear force and bending moment all along the length of beam, is it? All along the length of
beam.
What it means, suppose you have this beam, right? So it is subjected to some UDL. What will be its shear force? This will be its shear force diagram. What will be its bending moment? This is its bending moment diagram, is it?
Yes.
So this is its shear force diagram, and this is its bending moment diagram, right? This is negative, this is positive, everywhere it is positive. We can find the values. Okay, so if I take this section, right? So what is meaning of that? So this is value of shear force at this point, right?
Yes.
This is value of bending moment at this point. Agreed?
Yes.
Then what is meaning of this section? That over here, bending shear force is zero, bending moment is
maximum.
What about this one? That at this point, this is value of shear force and this is value of
bending moment.
So at every point along the length of beam, right? At every point, you can find the value of shear force bending moment. Easy, right? But in case of influence line diagram, the story is different. Okay? So in case of influence line diagram, so variation of reaction or shear force or bending moment, right, is observed only at single point, right? We observe that how the shear force or reaction or bending moment, it is changing at one point when the load is moving. Try to understand, this is the major difference, right? Over here, the ordinary shear force diagram, you can get the values at every point. But here, it's not like that. You will get the values of shear force only at one point, okay? Right? If you need at another point, you need to draw another diagram. So what is meaning of that? Now, for example, I have this simply supported beam, right? And over here, for example, this is A, this is B. This reaction is how much it is? This is RA, okay? And this reaction is RB. And I want to draw the ILD for RA, okay? Or ILD for shear force at some point, or ILD for bending moment. Concept is same, right? So first I am going to draw the ILD for RA. Agreed? So ILD for RA. First I am going to draw. So it is difficult for you to understand how to draw it, but I am giving you the figure, right? You know how to draw these figures, right?
Yes.
But here you don't know, but I am giving you the figure, right? Just to explain it. Suppose over here, so this will be your ILD for, this will be your ILD for shear, for reaction at A. ILD for, so what is meaning of that now? So what is this diagram, okay? So this diagram shows, first, whenever ILD is there, so first thing which will be in your mind, it is what? That it is for the unit load, okay? And unit load is moving all along the length of beam. What is second point? The ILD is only for one point, not for every point, okay? So here, what is our point? It is RA. So now, what this diagram shows us,
right? ILD for
so it is ILD for RA. Now, try to understand, it means, so what are these different ordinates? What are these different ordinates, okay? So these ordinates are, this shows that if your load is here, your unit load is here, okay, then this is the value of reaction at A. If your load is here, after this one, right? Now load is here, right? So it means this is the reaction at A. So if your load is here, right? Only one, right? Then over here, this is value of reaction at A. So all these ordinates, they show that when load is here, the RA is this much, zero, right? So when load, unit load is here, so this is the value of reaction at A. So we are observing only one point. Agreed? Clear? So this, okay, by the way, when unit load is here, what will be this reaction?
The same.
So okay, can you understand
one.
This concept?
Yeah.
Okay, so this ILD, it gives you the value of the required function. We use the word function, right? So this is a function, right? ILD for RA, this is a function, okay? So this diagram, this gives us the values, right? For example, if unit load is here, this is value of RA. Here, this is value of RA. Here, this is value of RA. Agreed? Now, let me redraw this figure, right? Over here again. Okay. Now, in this figure, again it is ILD for RA, is it? So, here is our RA. This is our RB, right? Okay. Now, for example, and I told you that for this case, this is the value of this is the shape of ILD for
RA.
Okay, now forget about this thing, okay? So if your unit load, if unit load is here, right? Okay, if unit load is here, what will be value of RB?
One.
I am asking about RB, right?
One.
Okay, if your unit load is here, can you find RA and RB?
The opposite.
So what is value of RB? It is?
One.
RA is?
Zero,
right? So you know when unit load is here, this is, okay, when your unit load is in the middle,
half.
Mm-hmm.
0.5.
Half will be here, half will be here.
Yes.
Right? When your unit load is here, right?
Zero.
This will be
one,
this will be
zero.
And I think you can get the same things over here. When your unit load is here, what is this value?
One.
RA
is zero. Yes.
RA is?
Zero.
Zero, right? When your unit load is here, right? So what is RA? It is
one.
And you can get again this value. If your unit load is in the middle, this is one, this is complete length, it is straight line. What it will be 0.5, is it?
Yeah.
Okay? So if your unit load is here, this is the value of
RA.
Okay? So if your unit load is here, right? So this will be the value of RA.
So
similarly,
one figure can be enough to find the RA and RB?
No. So this is only for RA. This is only for one function. Okay? That's what I told you, that variation or reaction, variation of reaction, shear force, bending is observed only at one point.
But the rest it will be at RB, you know? For example.
You are right. We can assess, but we draw the figure only for one. Okay, now another example of shear force to explain you a little bit more, right? Now, if I, for the same beam, right? I'm going to draw it over here. Now for reaction, for shear force, okay? So this is point A, this is point B. Suppose this length is 4 meters, right? And I am asking you to draw ILD for reaction at a distance of 1 meter. ILD for shear force at a distance 1 meter from the spot, okay? So this is point A, this is B, this is C. Now I want to find how the shear force, now try to understand, how the shear force at point C, it will change when unit load will move along the length, okay? So when unit load is here, what is value of shear force at C? When unit load is here, what is value of shear force at C? Unit load is here, what is the shear force at C? So only discussion is about shear force at C, or bending moment at C. Agrees? Clear? So for that one, I can tell you what will be its diagram just for the discussion. So its diagram for ILD, it will be like that. Okay. So this is positive, this is negative. So this will be 0.75, this is 0.25. Forget about that, how we draw it. Okay. First, this is its diagram. So this is ILD for
C.
Shear force at
C.
So what is meaning of that diagram now? What is meaning of that diagram? That if your unit load is here, if your unit load is here, right? Then
the shear force
at C is
zero.
If your unit load is here, right? Then it moves here, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
So this is the value of
shear force at C.
If your unit load, it moves here, right? Then this is the value of shear force at point
C.
So all these ordinates, they gives us the location of unit load and your value that required point. Okay. Now, for example, your unit load is here, right? So what it means that this is the value of shear force at point C. If your load comes here, right? So this is the value of, so all these ordinates, right? If your unit load is here, right? So this is the value of shear force at C.
Doctor, what if the point load is at C?
So if your unit load is exactly over here, so this will give you the value of shear force at C.
So
one. Okay? I draw it from here to here. Okay? So then this is the value of shear force at point C. Agreed? So now you understand what is the difference, right? The major difference is, in case of ordinary shear force bending moment, load can have any value. It can have any type, right? But here, there is only one unit moving load, right? And it moves all along the length of beam. Second difference, here, in ordinary shear force bending moment diagram, we get the value of shear force bending moment at this point, every point, right? Right? So this is value of shear force over here, bending moment over here. At, if you cut a section over here, this is shear force here, at every point, okay? At every point along the length of beam, you have the shear force and bending moment value, right? But in case of ILDs, right, we observe only one point. Because it is clear from its name, right? It is influence line diagram, and we called it, and we translated it in Arabic as tasir, right? That we are trying to observe the tasir of moving load at one point only, okay? Its effect, its variation, right? So, and I showed you these two examples, right? So this is, for example, we want to draw ILD for reaction. So it means at every point, for example, if your unit load is here, this is value of reaction over here. If load is here, then this is value of reaction over here. Same is for shear force, same is for bending moment. Okay? Right? So you know that clearly what is ILD, okay? Now next one is how to draw the ILD, okay? Next part is to draw ILD. So basically, we have three methods, or you can say, following are the three methods to draw the, following are the three methods to draw the ILD. First one is, by tabulating the values I earn these by tabulating the values. Second one is ILD by tabulating the value. Second one is ILD by using function or equation. Functions or you can say equations. Then last one is ILD by Mueller principle. M-U-L-L-E-R. Mueller's principle. And last one is, okay, there is another fourth method, but we will discuss it when we finish all these three. Okay. So now, ILD you can draw by any of these methods. Your result will be same. Okay. So either you use this method, this one, and final result is same. Okay. Because this is final shape. So let's start our discussion. ILD by tabulating values. Okay. ILD by tabulating. Okay, anyone who can get the idea, the best way, how we can draw the ILD, some sense or any simple idea to draw the ILD.
Assume the
no, see, what is ILD? We have to find this point, and this point. So what you can do, place unit dot over here, okay, and find the reactions numerically, okay? This will give you this value, right? Place unit load over here, find RA, this will give you this ordinate. Mm-hmm. Then place unit load over here, find RA, this will give you this ordinate. Just draw these 3 points, join it.
It's always a straight line?
Yes. Another interesting thing about ILD is it is always a straight line, okay? Either it is for shear force, for bending movement, right? For any beam, right? So it is always straight line. Okay.
So what you did, you will.
Then it is not ILD.
Oh, so it should be point load.
This one, a unit load moving along the length of beam is considered. Okay. Right. Okay. And by the way, have you ever seen a unit load moving on the bridge?
No.
Never. Is it?
Yeah.
Can you understand my question?
Yes.
Have you ever seen only, huh? It is moving load, it is unit moving load, it has four tires, not one tire. Have you ever seen any car which has one tire? Even the bike has two tires, right? So it is not possible. But basically, now the interesting thing is, as your friend is saying, that we will convert our ILD. Now, first we will draw it for unit moving load, right? And then, at this point of view, we will convert it, okay, to any case, either it will be a UDL moving, a truck is moving, a train is moving, we can convert this diagram at later stage easily, right? So by definition, we draw it for the unit moving load. Then we have simple techniques to convert it for
unit
any case. Okay. Okay. Now let's start our discussion by ILD by tabulating values. Okay, so we draw the ILD for a reaction, for a function, right? So we need to draw. We draw ILD for a function.
This will follow the question for time.
How much time to go?
15.
15 more minutes?
Yes. No.
Okay, just let let me explain this word. So ILD for a function. Do you know what is meaning of function?
Yes.
Function
has
means
variable.
Function means the shear, the reaction is a function. ILD for shear force at a point is a function, right? ILD for bending movement at a point is a function, right? Means what is meaning of function? So it means ILD for reaction, shear force, bending movement. I can write it like this way. We draw ILD for reaction, shear force, bending movement, blah blah blah, right? But we make it short, right? So ILD for a function can be drawn by using following steps. Okay. Okay. Next time I will write these three or four steps, and then we apply it to some simple cases. Okay. Okay. So now it's time for the meter.
Meter?
Not meter, right? Sorry, I'm a little bit confused. Okay, so you will have four lines, okay? One over there.